Okay, since my antenna is acting, nope. I'm going have to do it like this. Looking forward to this, even though I watched some of it already. I'm gonna have to watch over some of them again. There we go.
Ms. Mojo, and this is my sister Emily, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 cartoon sisters we love. Before we begin, we publish new content every day,
I'm
so be
so
sure to
better
subscribe
with
to our channel and ring the bell to get
the other
notified about
thing,
our latest videos.
but no,
We are paying tribute to some of
seems to
our
have to
favorite small
be.
screen ladies that drive their siblings crazy, whether
Oh.
they're butting heads or simply showing their family some love. We are not limiting it to one sister. It could be two, three, sometimes even 10. However, we are not including any siblings from films that were adapted into TV shows like Lilo and Nani. All right, let's get to the
would
list. I shouldn't have yelled at you.
check to see
We're sisters. It's our job.
this, but
Number 10,
that'd be
Applejack and
cheating.
Apple Bloom. My Little Pony
Okay.
Friendship is Magic. Applejack is the
I'm
hardworking
actually
middle
in the
child with
last
sweet
season
apple
now.
fingers and the
Just
bearer of
bored.
the element of honesty.
Woohoo!
Apple Bloom is the youngest of the
Make
apple
sure
siblings
the
and one of the
5G
founding
comes
fillies
out.
of the Cutie Mark
Oh,
Crusaders.
comments.
Why wouldn't you
Yeah!
just listen to your fake
And
sister?
see what it's like.
Who knows what kind of nasty curse the car could have just put on you? The two share a typical tight southern sisterhood.
See
Although Apple Bloom
what
tends
they
to be
would
a
be
little too
like
eager to grow up or help
in
out,
the
while Applejack
5G.
can act a little overprotective towards her baby sister. Despite their quirks, they have one of the tightest sisterly bonds in the show, while also making time to give a little love to their less talkative big brother, Big Mac, showing that they truly are apples to the core.
You're right. It is hard work. That's why we do it together.
Number 9. Lori, Lenny, Luna, Luann, Lynn Jr., Lucy,
So
Lana,
seems
Lola,
that has no
Lisa,
ending
and
to it
Lily
yet.
Loud, the Loud House. Since the Louds can take up the
Great!
entire list, we're bringing them together for
Just gotta
one
keep on
solo.
going and going and
Alrighty then.
going,
We are
isn't
dressed and fed, and now we have our backpacks and lunches prepared to dietary needs. We're just waiting on Lori. Inspired by the creator's own family, Lick and
Certainly
Loud finds himself
a
caught in the
bit
middle of 10
wobbly.
sisters, each with their own distinct,
Not each
creative,
just doing like
over-the-top
this.
personality and ambitions.
Guys! Please stay out of this! You only make it worse! If by worse, you mean better, I agree.
These ladies butt heads with Lincoln, and often each other, meddle in his life, and generally make the world more chaotic for their only brother. Peace and tranquility becomes almost non-existent in the Loud House.
Oh, camel clutch! Another good option for you.
While it doesn't sound like an ideal situation, Lincoln
When
wouldn't
I've got
trade
to
his
save up
sisters for the
this.
world if he could. And the sisters all agree that Lincoln truly is the best dang brother.
I'm sad this picture probably isn't that good right now.
Number 8, Candace Gertrude Flynn, Phineas and Ferb. Candace is Phineas's biological older sister and
Really
Ferb's older
sad that
stepsister. When the boys
that
start scheming
thing
for summer
it ended.
shenanigans, she'll go out of her way to try and expose their harebrained schemes to their
She really
parents.
good.
See? I told you I'm not crazy! I told you! And you're not crazy because.
Unfortunately, such a feat is easier said than done, as her brothers can easily become electronics, and being constantly foiled by them drives poor Candace batty.
Oh God.
But they're still
Not
Candace's little
sure if
brothers,
this line
and
is
she
high
loves them
enough
very
on
much
this
and cares about their safety.
laptop,
The
but
boys don't really
we'll
notice
do.
Candace's attempts to get them busted, and genuinely feel like they couldn't ask for a better big sister.
But Candace, the disc, you didn't save it.
What? And let you fall? You may be a pain, but you are my brother.
Number 7, Dee, Dexter's Laboratory. There is a pesky problem in Dexter's Laboratory. In the form of his ditzy, hyperactive big sister Dee Dee. Hi, Dexter! When Dee Dee comes around, disaster usually follows for Dexter's scientific creations. Although, to be fair, she doesn't do it to be mean, it's just that curiosity gets the better of her and her little brother's work.
Yes, remove yourself from my laboratory!
Not her
So
forte,
angry
Dee
now.
Dee is shown to actually be wise in subjects that Dexter's too smart to understand, such as nature, inner peace, and how to have fun.
Okay, now your makeup.
Oh.
frustration towards her. She genuinely loves her little brother and only wants to spend time with him, even if it means sabotaging his work.
That's right, Dexter. And no matter where you go, no matter where you sleep, no matter what you eat, I will be there. Like a stealth ninja polar bear waiting to pounce on its next unsuspecting victim. For I am Diddy Snowball Warrior!
Number 6. Dot Warner, also known as Princess Angelina Contessa Louisa Francesca Banana Fana Vobesca III, Animaniacs. Dottie, and she will make you suffer.
We're the Warner Brothers.
And the Warner sister.
Dot is the youngest of the Warner siblings, and arguably the cutest of them all. She'll go to bizarre lengths to maintain her adorable image.
Being cute, a thing you can't hide. If you look up the word in the book, there's my picture inside.
She gets along well with her two brothers, always happy and eager to join in on their shenanigans. But she gets annoyed easily when the two start flirting with girls, despite how she acts when she sees a handsome guy around.
Hello, Mel!
I'd like to see Mr. Plotz.
He's busy. Let's talk about
it. On the outside, she's a sweet little lady. But on the inside, she can be vain, pushy, and possibly even zanier than Yakko and Wacko combined. But we can't deny how cute she really is.
Please let us out of the cagey wagey.
Oh, you're working your weirdness on me, man. Your cute weirdness. Okay, I'll let you out.
Some girls got it, some girls don't.
Number 5, Meg Griffin, Family Guy. When she's not acting as the series Patsy, Meg is the eldest child of the Griffin family, followed by her two brothers, Chris and Stewie. While they don't interact as much, Meg will try to be a good big sister to Stewie.
Do you want a hug from your big sister?
Too bad he doesn't usually give her the same respect.
Hold it, Meg. Those two are mine.
What? Meg and Chris will butt heads every now and then, bickering like your average brother and sister and even taking advantage of each other from time to time.
The important thing is that you stood up for me, and I won't forget it.
Despite this, Chris and Meg look out for each other.
Going on, or is
well
it?
Together when absolutely necessary. Though they have been shown to take their bonding a little too far.
Chris?
Meg?
Number 4. Mabel Pines, Gravity.
Yay! We're gonna miss that show.
5-minute older twin sister.
It was just so good.
Creator Alex Hirsch's actual twin sister.
Mabel was my favorite one.
Becomes obsessed with the strange company surrounding Gravity Falls, Mabel is more focused on the simple pleasures of summer, such as chasing after boys or getting creative with arts and crafts.
Okay, hit it, boys! Who's that girl with the pig and braces? She puts smiles on everyone's face.
Despite their conflicting priorities, Mabel is always ready to back Dipper up when it comes to dealing with the supernatural perils. Which is good, since Dipper admits that she's the main reason he stands a chance.
I just need to think positive, be friendly, and everything will work out fine.
Their summer in Gravity Falls won't last forever. But Mabel is more than ready to face reality as long as she's got her twin by her side.
You're letting them take our argument to court?
Hey, I didn't make the rules in Mableland.
Yes, you did. There's a tapestry of you making the rules.
Number 3, Louise and Tina Belcher, Bob's Burgers. All three Belcher kids are a riot on their own. But for this list, we're giving it up to the oldest and youngest of the trio.
Unless you're Jimmy Jr. and you're here to kiss my lips, I don't want to talk to you.
Tina is the elder sister. And a monotone, socially inept, hopeless romantic who loves horses, rainbows, and writing some rather bizarre.
This video is so gonna get copyrighted.
Louise may look like a sweet, normal little girl in a pink hat, but underneath those bunny ears is a manipulative, deceitful devil who thrives on conflict.
Don't ever mess with us.
This is so gonna get copyrighted.
Get the hell out of here.
Huh? Yeah, that's how you do it. That's how you do it.
Oh, obviously,
this.
I just know once I upload it, I'm gonna get copyrighted.
This and hilarity are guaranteed to follow, especially
big time.
I'm sorry, I was into you guys.
I just figured you were having female troubles.
What are female troubles?
I love you too, Louise.
Number 2, Blossom.
Yay! Love them.
They're the iconic Cartoon Network super.
I don't like the reboot. I like the original.
Spice, everything nice.
I actually love the original. Hate the remake.
Blossom is the level-headed leader and brains of the trio. Bubbles is the sweet part of the group, who can easily go hardcore if you push the wrong buttons. And Buttercup is the tough-as-nails tomboy of the three.
We got to the observatory! Mojo, rescue you! Here we are! Can we go home now?
They'll bicker and argue like any normal siblings their age, but when the city of Townsville is in peril. They'll quickly band together to lace up fast-paced crime fighting against the forces of evil and save the world. All before bedtime, no less.
Excuse me, Mr. Monster? I was wondering if you would be so kind as to stop destroying Townsville. We like our town very, very much.
Before we unveil our number one pick, here are some honorable mentions.
You know, we're like only 4 hours out of Nairobi. Why don't we hop in the combi and go have breakfast there?
You mean with a table and a waitress?
Hey, May, can I borrow your
money? Ugh, hate that show in them. God.
When you were in the kids next door,
used to watch that.
Just like you.
Don't like
you
it. Oh my god.
Number one, Lisa Marie and Margaret Maggie Simpson. The Simpsons. Lisa is the scholarly middle child with a knack for the saxophone.
Still going on to the day.
Mr. Honey Bunny, you're a human monster. You want a piece of me?
Maggie is the pastor's favorite. Who is secretly very bright for an infant, but who may also harbor a secret dark side.
That's the one.
While they're worlds apart, they keep a strong sisterly bond, and both venture through eerily similar struggles, being bright, self-sufficient young women overlooked by their peers, and sharing a rather complex relationship with the rest of their family.
Why is it when a woman is confident and powerful, they call her a witch?
Only a select few fully understand their sisterhood, but it helps them stand out even more as the young ladies of one of the most iconic cartoon families in history.
That was actually a really good episode.
Let us know what you think in the comments, and if you have any fun sibling moments, be sure to like and subscribe and check out these other videos, and also give your sister a hug.
Okay, that was my reaction to Miss Mojo's top 10 cartoon sisters we love. So I will try and sort out my bunny into on my phone, or I'll get back to do live streams. Until then, Pizza Fighter, sign out. Oh, and like, comment, and subscribe, and peace out.